this lesson is titled Adding Integers. In integers, if we kind of look back at the realm of the type of numbers in the real number system, remember integers are whole numbers, like the counting numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as well as their opposites. So negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. So really what we're doing here is we're adding with positive and negative numbers. And there's some rules that can help us with that. And there are a couple different ways to think about it. You can use specifically rules as kind of a mnemonic device to remember how to add the numbers. Or you can use a number line as a process, or you can use integer chips as a process. And all of these processes, as you start to do them on paper, they're going to become ingrained in your brain so that you don't have to really memorize the rules anymore. They're just going to be there. And when you get into higher math, eighth grade, algebra one, you're not really going to have to think or use integer chips. You're just going to know what the answer to negative 5 plus negative 8 is. I do have a couple handouts for you. One is adding rational numbers practice. That's going to go eventually on the left side. And then we have our flippable book that's going to go on the right side. And you're going to cut these out. Before we do that, though, I want to get into some definitions. So we're going to write DEF as a definition. So one definition is called the additive inverse. When you're adding a number and its opposite, you should get zero. So an additive inverse is two numbers that add to zero. So if you're trying to find the additive inverse of, say, 2, for example, that additive inverse would be negative 2. And I want you to put that in red. We're going to represent negative numbers in red, positive numbers in black, or sometimes blue, but negative always in red. If you put a pair of these together, they're called a zero pair. So 2 and negative 2 are zero pairs. And that's especially going to be important, and this additive inverse is going to be important when we start to do subtraction. But it's nice to have that definition in for adding, because in order to know what an additive inverse is, you have to know how to add integers. So first example is going to be really basic. What we're going to do is evaluate 2 plus 3 on a number line. And to do that, right, we first have to draw a number line. So an integer number line is when you start at, you can start at 0, you can start at any number. But the numbers that you're putting on here for your number line are integers. So you're not going to put in halves or fourths or, you know, eighths. You're going to want to put integers. So I have 0 and then I have 1, and it's additive inverse, negative 1, 2, negative 2, 3, negative 3, and so on. And it doesn't have to be balanced. You can keep going. But to evaluate 2 plus 3 on a number line, what you're going to do is you're going to start at 2. That's the number we start with here. And since we're adding 3, we're going to be moving to the right. So we're going to be going 1, 2, 3 to the right. So 2 plus 3 is 5. It's a pretty basic example, but I want to show you how we move with the number line with positive numbers. My second example is going to be to evaluate negative 2 plus negative 4 on a number line. So for this one, don't get too tripped up by the notation here. See what it says? We have an addition symbol and a negative symbol. Negative and subtraction, they actually mean the same thing, which we'll get to in the next section. But we don't, as mathematicians, like to put operation symbols next to each other without there being some sort of number between. Like if this was negative 2 plus 6 minus 4, that would make sense. But it's not. It's negative 2 plus negative 4. So we're going to show that on the number line. We start at negative 2. And now I'm adding negative 4. That actually means that I'm going to the left, because these are the negative numbers. I'm adding more negative numbers. So negative 2 plus negative 4. So that's 4 jumps. And so what I have here, if this distance here is worth negative 2, and this distance is negative 4, together we get negative 6. So negative 2 plus negative 4 is negative 6. So as we turn the page, we're going to get into some problems where we're adding integers that have different signs. So we have a negative 12 and a positive 6. So we would read this out as negative 12 plus 6. And I'm actually going to show you how to do this on a vertical number line. When you start getting into graphing, you want to familiarize yourself with both horizontal and vertical number lines, because you're going to have to pair up numbers, and you pair up numbers by using two number lines together, one vertical, one horizontal, but you'll get there. So first we're going to evaluate negative 12 plus 6. So we're starting at negative 12, so that's right here on my number line. Okay, and I'm going to be adding 6 to it. So when I add 6, I'm adding 6 positive numbers. So if I think of this distance here as being negative 12, I'm going to be adding 6 positive numbers to that. And I'm going to show that jump in black because it's a positive jump. So 6 positive would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I land here. So negative 12 plus 6 is going to give me negative 6. And that's how you show it on the number line, right here, where this distance and this distance right here is negative 6. So we're going to do one last example. We're going to be evaluating 8 plus negative 10. This time, we're not going to use a number line, but we're going to use integer chips. So in the classroom, if your teacher has them, pull out some integer chips, and those will probably be two-sided. One side's usually yellow and one side is usually red. So red's going to represent the negative and yellow will represent the positive. I like red and black chips. So if you have red and black chips, those are usually the best ones. Not all people have those chips though. Now, I actually don't have chips physically with me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to represent this addition by drawing 8 positive chips. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And it's kind of like a number line if you think about it. And then I have 10 negative chips. So let's add those ones to you. Negative, 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 negative. Kind of look like frowning faces. Until I get 10. Now, we talked earlier about the definition of additive inverses. And additive inverses, or zero pairs, when you add two things and they become zero. So these chips here are what's called zero pairs. We can actually cross them off because they're zero. Zero pair, right? And you can keep crossing off these negative chips until you have what's remaining. When you can't take any more zero pairs away, this is what you have left. So this one would equal, now that I've taken away all of my positive chips, I have two negatives left, so that's negative two. What we're gonna be working with now is this handout here. So you're gonna follow along with the directions. It says to cut along the dashed lines and fold along the bold line. So be really careful you don't mess this up, because you don't wanna have to go and get another packet and then have this one missing paper from a packet that someone else is gonna grab, and they're not gonna have all their material. So pay very close attention to the directions. I'm gonna go ahead and cut this out. You can pause the video, and then when you come back to the video, it'll be cut out. Welcome back. Now you should have these two tabs out. What you're going to do is take this one that says adding rational numbers with different signs, and you're gonna either tape or glue it down into or onto your notebook. And you don't need a lot of glue, just kind of around the edges. And I like to like put an X here just to make sure that you can glue that just right into the middle. I like to make the lines match up a little bit. And there you go. That one should be glued in. Now this second one here, we're actually not gonna glue it on top of the whole thing, because then we would ruin it. What you're going to do is you're gonna fold this down along this edge here. And I'll show you why, because now you're either gonna take tape, or if you have some glue, and you're gonna glue this right to here so that it all lines up. Okay, so you could either do what I just did with the glue, or you can take your tape and tape it along there. But basically what we have now is we have something that flips up. It's a little flip book here. Okay, and this is just the rules that I was talking about before, that you're gonna, you know, you'll get used to having these in your head. But when you're adding rational numbers, and we're doing this with integers, but these rules can be used for all numbers. When you're adding rational numbers with the same sign, you add the value of the numbers and you keep their sign. So for example, 2.5 plus 3.5 is 6. These were both positives, so we just added the 2.5, the 3.5, and we got 6. Now here's where you can see where this rule really makes sense. -4 plus -7 equals -11. So you could show that with a number line, but you can also think about it as, well, you have 4 negatives here, so that's 4. 7 negatives here, so that's 7. When I add 4 and 7, I get 11, so that means I should have 11 total negative numbers. Now, conversely, the rules for adding numbers with different signs is you subtract the value of the two numbers and use the sign of the number with a higher value. And for this, you want to kind of think about integer chips, right? So you have 4.5, which is a positive number. I'll put a little plus there. And we're adding -7.5. So obviously you have more negatives than you do positives. So your answer is going to be negative, right? You have more negative chips than positive chips. When you start taking those zero pairs away, you're going to end up with negative chips left. So in this case, what they're doing is they're saying, well, what's the difference? If I take away the 4.5 positive chips from here, I'm left with 3 negative. So negative 3. And the same thing for this one here. This should be a bold. It's not a double negative sign. This is 2 plus negative 3, right? So if you have 2 and you're adding negative 3, you're going to end up with 2 zero pairs, and then you have negative 1 left. So really what they're telling you is that you're subtracting the value of the numbers. So this is really 3 minus 2, which is 1. This had a bigger absolute value, so it's negative 1. 7.5 minus 4.5 is 3. This was negative, it's bigger, so it's negative 3. So that's kind of the point. That just kind of summarizes what we just did there with a number line. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take this foldable following the same directions, and you're going to put that over here as your practice problems. So you can go ahead and cut that out. All right, so you followed careful directions. You should have this. Remember, you're just cutting along the dashed edges. And what you're going to do now is you are going to fold this up. Just like so. And you're going to take the back and you're going to tape or glue the back side here. You don't want to go all the way to the top because then this tab is going to be a little bit over. So you might want to bring it down just a little bit. Now your goal is to take each of these problems and you're going to solve them on this underside here. So you're going to do negative 1.5 plus 4. You're going to do that right here. And then when you're done, you're going to call your teacher over so they can check your answers and make sure you did it correctly. Okay. And I also want you to practice using the number line. So I'm going to give you 2 extra problems to do using the number line. And so I added some problems for you to do at the bottom. So using a number line, evaluate the following. 1 plus 3, negative 3 plus negative 6, 2 plus negative 4, and negative 8 plus 13. Last thing we have to do is we have to keep titling this. So this is called adding integers. And when you're done with all of these problems, again, you're going to show your teacher, and then they're going to check, make sure you understand what you're doing, and you can move on to the practice.